What's up everybody, Robin Visuals here and welcome back to the vlog series. Some of you might have recognized that because this week we are doing a photo by Peter McKinnon. He is a Canadian photographer and videographer and he's all around a great guy on YouTube. Really like his stuff. He's got two Instagram accounts and on one of those, Pete's Private Life, he recently posted a nice flat lay photo. It looks really cool. And this week we're gonna use that for the vlog series in which I find a photo that looks really cool, analyze it, create a photo like it with my own twist, and compare it to, which I still need a name for. I know I asked for it in the last vlog and I don't know if anybody responded yet because I haven't posted it yet. So either way, if you still have a good name, let me know. We're gonna go to analyzing Robin for the analysis of this very cool photo. Thank you so much, intro Robin. I am analyzing Robin from the analyzing department of Robin Visuals. And today we're gonna look at this photo by Peter McKinnon at his Instagram account, Pete's Private Life. And there are a couple of things that are important when analyzing a photo. The first of which is light. The second I will call composition, and the third will be contrast, kind of, in this photo. First, light. As you can see in this photo, there's very much diffuse lighting. So I think he used an overhead lighting source with a diffuser. So for this, I will use my little aperture MC with the diffuser cap on it. Or I will light it straight from above. Then we will talk about composition. Composition is a flat lay. All of the objects are in a 2D plane. His hand is the only thing that's kind of out of the plane. It also makes the shot a bit more interesting because it is an action. The hand is doing an action and that is, makes it more interesting than just a static flat lay. Then onto contrast. This consists of two parts in this one. The first is textures. I know I followed Peter McKinnon for a while now and I know that he loves to use textures. So you can see this here in the table. The table has a lot of texture and the black overlay thingy does not have a lot of texture. And there's also contrasting colors. There is the brown colors and the black colors mainly, and then there's some white or grayish aspects. So there's a very monochromatic color scheme in this photo and that makes it pleasing to look at, in my opinion. The objects that are used in this photo are typical for Peter McKinnon, but I will use different objects because I will take a photo of objects I have and I find interesting. I hope I have enough because he has a lot of those. So now I will take you on to setup Robin. Hey guys, so this is setup Robin. As you have seen in the shot, there's a brown coffee table or wooden background. We will use my coffee table for that. And then to take the shot as well, we will use, let me just move on here. I will use my clothing rack back there. I will empty it and I will move it over to the coffee table. And then I will use my aperture MC light, which is this one. And I will just plug it to this. And I will use my my Joby GorillaPod, or my mom's old Joby GorillaPod, to fasten my camera to it. I need to take the other camera off and then I will have a setup. I will get going with that. You guys just enjoy and I'll send you off to photographer Robin afterwards. Hey guys, this is photographer Robin. from the photography department of Robin Visuals. As you can see, my room is a mess, but I actually wanted to show you the setup. So I have the items, those are ready. Next up, we'll take care of the settings. So as you can see in the photo, everything in the photo is sharp. As it is a flat lay, it doesn't really need that much depth of field, but the hand is kind of above the rest. So we will use something like a 5.6, and if not everything is sharp, we'll just go up. Then for the focal length, since there's no movement of the hand, it should be at least 1/2 the focal length, but preverably more towards 1/200, so that my hand doesn't really move. And the ISO I will just put on auto as a maximum of, I don't know, like 3200. And if it doesn't get enough light, I will allow it to go higher. Now I will go and take the photos and I will get back to you with editing Robin. So see you in a few. Hey guys, this is Summary Vibes editing Robin. It has been a couple of weeks and I've edited the photo 2 weeks ago. I filmed the rest 2 weeks ago as well. So today it is time for me to take some time, or after having taken some time, to review the photo that I took and see how it compares to the original. So you can see the original here. And just a quick re-evaluation. I still really like the photo. And after a quick look again at my final photo, I'm pretty proud of what I've created. But I noticed that I have too little objects in the photo and it is too zoomed in, kind of. That has to do with my setup and the possibilities that I had here. But considering my restraints, I am pretty proud of what I've created. And yeah, I think that is the point. To create within your limits and try to overcome those. So that is it for this video. I'm looking forward to seeing you again in 2 weeks. That is when the new video will be out. I don't know what it will be about yet. If you have any cool photos that you've seen, let me know. And in the meantime, just keep creating.